The robotic revolution is coming, but it's not the dystopian era of the Terminators. Instead, this new age of automation and software is designed to make you more money with less work. In this video, I'll show you how software and automation can help you invest smarter. We'll look at the features available on robo-advisors and how they work. I'll show you the pros and cons to this new way to invest, and then reveal three questions you need to ask before getting started. We're talking robo-investor platforms today on Let's Talk Money. Nation, you know we love picking stocks here on the channel and that idea of DIY investing, but the tragedy is that your biggest challenge to reaching your financial goals is sometimes yourself. Data from JP Morgan shows the average investor earned just 2.9% annually over the 20 years from 2000. That return of less than 3% is well under the 7.5% annualized return on stocks in the S&P 500, and even under a safer bond portfolio, which earned 5% a year. Between letting emotions and bad investor behaviors get in the way to panic selling at the wrong time, investors destroy their returns on stocks. And worse yet, many investors already know this, but feel powerless to stop. You watch your portfolio value shrink, your stocks fall, and you know it's because of those bad decisions, but like any gambling addict, addicted to that thrill of trading, you just can't stop. The solution? Using that revolution in investing software and robo-advisors to help manage a part of your portfolio. Now, my own worst enemy or not, I will never stop investing my money, and I wouldn't expect you to either. The solution isn't to fully swear off investing and let the robots take over, but to let them help, putting some of your money in a robo-advisor platform while you invest the rest, like a cyborg investing strategy. And you see a lot of talk about that artificial intelligence in robo-advisors, but the truth is, most robo-platforms just run on software based on modern portfolio theory that invests your money to minimize those market risks while maximizing returns. It does this by aligning your risk tolerance and goals with different assets and diversification within those assets. I want to start with a quick rundown of how robo-advisors work, pros and cons, and then questions you need to ask before getting started. But first, I want to thank Wealthfront for sponsoring this video. Using the best of the features we'll talk about, Wealthfront helps you create a portfolio based on your goals to combine the power of automated investing with customized options that you won't find on other robo-advisors. In fact, I can show you a product demo that Wealthfront put together so you know what to expect and the features that really sets it apart. Now, like most robo-advisors, you'll start out with a few questions on your goals and how much risk you're comfortable taking. Now, I'm using an existing account here, so it already has the age and some of those other questions answered. It's then gonna ask you about your income, your current investments, all to get a sense of what your spending needs are and where you're starting from. Wealthfront can help keep your goals like retirement and education separate to make sure your investments in each of those are focused on that goal. And the platform is great for walking you through each of these, helping you understand how your answer to each question helps align your needs and your investments. Now from this, the platform is going to suggest a diversified portfolio of low-cost index funds based on your individual risk tolerance. And what I really like about Wealthfront though is the level of customization it gives you. You can adjust the overall risk in your portfolio or even the amount in individual funds by moving these sliders to adjust the percentage of your money in each. For example, if I want to add individual funds, I can just click on the browse for themes or specific investments. I can add some funds for more growth here and even some crypto trusts to the portfolio. Really, Wealthfront just makes it easy to see all your accounts, from accounts on different investment goals like retirement or general investing, and even linking your external accounts and credit cards to see your net worth and how much you owe. The minimum to get started on Wealthfront is just $500 with an annual fee of 0.25%, but you can get up to $5,000 managed for free when you sign up through my link below. I'll leave a link to Wealthfront in the description below, so check that out. And looking at how software is being used in investing, you start to see why this is such a great tool to help you reach your goals. The platform is going to set you up with a percentage of your money in each of a group of ETFs, depending on your risk tolerance and other factors like your age and your goals. This is where that modern portfolio theory comes in. The software takes your answers to questions about how much risk you can stomach, how much you need for your goals, and how long you have to get there, and then invests everything for you. The software is then gonna monitor your portfolio every single day, rebalancing those investments to keep you on track with the right amount of risk and return. This is something that most investors just don't realize, that need to adjust their stocks and bonds regularly, because most investors are just picking stocks without any idea of asset allocation. For example, even if you start out with your own portfolio of say 80% in stocks and 20% in bonds, after a year or two of a strong stock market returns, that portfolio might be 90% in stocks, leaving you dangerously exposed to a market crash. Now, for individual investors, it's just too easy to get caught up in that bull market, think stocks will never go down, and keep that 90% invested until it's too late. With a robo-advisor doing this for you, though, you've got automatic rebalancing to keep you diversified. For me, by far the best use of the software in the robo-advisors, though, is that automatic tax loss harvesting. This is a strategic selling of some investments each year and rebalancing to help lower your taxes. Now, like that rebalancing, this is something you can do on your own, but you've got to ask yourself if you've been doing it as well as you should. A robo-advisor like Wealthfront is going to monitor your portfolio every day, rebalance in that tax-optimized way, and even take advantage of tax loss harvesting opportunities to help lower your taxes owed. And of course, the bonus to all this is that those robo-advisors are going to do all this within one fee. You get that goals-based portfolio, automatic rebalancing, and tax loss harvesting all done for you for a 0.25% fee annually. Pros of using a robo-advisor are that it takes a lot of the stress out of investing. You've got your money in broad, diversified index funds and across assets, so you know a single stock or even a stock crash isn't going to wipe you out. You've got your investments aligned with your long-term goals, and you're on that path to reaching them. Another upside here is even after paying that management fee, robo-advisors can be less costly than investing on your own. Nation, between trading in and out of stocks and investing in some of the most expensive ETFs, investors just can't get out of their own way. But with a robo-advisor like Wealthfront, you know your ETFs have already been vetted based on the expense ratio, liquidity, and volatility, always looking for that optimal funds in each asset class. Now, that means more of your money can stay in the market. Of course, the downside is that, for me anyway, using a robo-advisor takes some of that fun and control out of investing. And that's why I'm using that cyborg approach, investing part of my wealth in a robo-advisor for that goals-based return while holding some of it back to invest myself. Now, there are a lot of robo-advisors out there, so I want to make sure you have the tools to find the one that's going to fit your needs. Doing this comes down to asking yourself three questions before investing on a platform. First, what are the fees and minimum investment on the platform? And most robo-advisors charge a per month or annual fee as a percentage of how much you have invested. This should never be more than 1%, but the best platforms are going to charge 0.5% or less, like Wealthfront, which charges 0.25% annually. You'll also want to make sure the ETFs the platform uses are low cost, so the annual expense ratio for holding those funds is less than 0.5% on average. For example, the average expense ratio on the Wealthfront recommended classic portfolio is between 0.05% to 0.13% annually. Now, you'll also want to check out the ETFs and the funds available on the platform, and if that level of control you want is there. For example, even though Wealthfront can automatically invest your money across funds and percentages according to your needs, you can always adjust these percentages for a little more control over where your money goes. Last here, and a critical question most investors ask too late, is how is customer service? Robo-advisors and, well, investing platforms in general are notorious for poor customer service. Now, letting the robots help you invest shouldn't mean they're running the phones as well. So call up the platforms first or send an email. See how long it takes to get a response on any of your questions. Check out Wealthfront and get that special sign-up bonus with the link below, or click on the video to the right to see how investing just $1 a day can reach your investing goals along with the 5 stocks I'm watching. Don't forget to join the Let's Talk Money community by tapping that subscribe button and clicking the bell notification.